So whilst we're here at Hunt's in session, I just thought I'd take some time out to explain a little bit about fish care. Now, I know it's been done before and it will be done again. However, it is probably the most important aspect of whilst we're fishing on the bank, making sure that you care for the carp when they're out of the water, out of their comfort zone. Now, first of all, get everything prepped. So you can see here, I've got my mat, water to hand, a big amount of water as well. There's a large amount of water in there to make sure the fish is wet and cool during their time on the bank. I've also got a Carp Care kit here. So there's some antiseptic in there. I've got my scales, which have been zeroed, and I've got a towel as well. So what I can do with that is just dab the areas where there's maybe some damage on the fish, a scale lifted, for example, apply the Carp Care, and then obviously apply the water afterwards. So once this is all done, I've also got my camera kit ready, whether that be the self-take kit. Luckily, I've got the cameraman here today, so he's got the camera ready to go. It's all zoomed in, focused, etc., so that all I have to worry about is the fish, which is languishing in the sling in the edge now. So I'm gonna go and get it. So I'm down with the fish now, which is just languishing in the edge here, just in the sling. To be fair, after a long, hard fight, they've virtually run a marathon. So it's best, in my opinion, just to leave them in the edge, whether that be in the net or where obviously possible or applicable with the rules. Just allow them in one of the retention slings, just to have 5-10 minutes. It allows you to get the rod back out, maybe get some bait out there again where rules apply, and just gives them that time to recover. So what I'm gonna do is, obviously you can see we've got a nice long retention cord here. It's nice and deep in the edge as well. So we're not, certainly not too shallow, loads of weed, etc., where the oxygen's gonna be low. We'll come onto that later. But in regards to this, I'm gonna quickly whip her in, make sure all the fins are tucked in so there's no damage to the fish. Obviously it's been sat there for 5-10 minutes, so it might be a little bit lively. We'll get her out and take her to the mat. So we've got the fish on the mat now, simply transferred it from the edge onto the mat. Just gonna quickly unzip the sling, make sure everything's good. She's looking beautiful. Now it might be that she's a little bit lively, but we'll just double check, make sure that she hasn't got any cuts or abrasions on the body. Just be ever so gentle. You're actually looking very good, Nick. Very good, Nick. Just check the hook holes, if she'll let me. If they do flip, just cover their eyes. Just make them as calm as you possibly can. I've already applied a little bit of water, so I'm going to apply a little bit more. So I've just got plenty of water here. There we go. And then, yeah, just having a look at the mouth. There is a little hole where the hook was. So I've got some treatment there. What I'm going to do is just dab the area, just dry it with a cloth or a towel, which I've got here. Apply a little bit of Carp Care, a little bit of water, and that's just sealed that up lovely. Other than that, she's an immaculate common. I'll hold her up for you now, get some shots. What you'll also notice, I've taken off any jewellery, so I've taken off watches, rings, anything like that that might damage the carp. Hold her up for some pictures, and then we can pop her back. If they do flip or roll, just roll them back onto your forearms like so. They can kick and roll, and then you can hold them back up for your money shot. What a lovely fish. I like you. Let's get her back. So just before we slip her back, obviously we've got to weigh her. We've done all of the fish care stuff in regards to making sure there's antiseptic on the hook hold, etc., on the wounds and any wounds along the body. She's a really clean fish, so it was just on the hook hold. Not only that, but we took some good stills as well. Now we've got to weigh her. These are already zeroed. Like I said, everything's done. Calm down. Everything's done beforehand. Just check fins, etc. Although she's thrashing about, she's fine. There we go. So we'll quickly give her a weigh because she's getting active. And she is 22.8, so a nice low 20 common carp for the cameras. What we'll do is, again, just make sure everything's all right, everything's good, not going to trip over anything, and off we go. So as you can see, we're now back in the margins. First of all, please make sure the margins are deep enough. If you need to go to the swim next door or another area, please do. Please don't put them back in shallow water and they're splashing across the marginal gravel. We've just spent all that time looking after them. This is the last bit that you're gonna see them. Again, if they do need a bit of time, they've had a bit of a marathon out there. It might be that they've had a bit of a thrash about on the mat. Just let them relax, calm down. And again, just open the front of the sling. This one seems ready to go. Again, they'll kick, they'll tell you when they want to go. This is the part where you tell them you love them, see them again when they're bigger and all those other cliches. And she's just swum off of her own accord. None the worse for wear. If anything, hopefully, grateful for a little bit of antiseptic. And it just gives us the time and the ability to look after them. We put them through a bit of, a bit of turmoil. So it's nice to give them a little bit back and make sure that they're safe when they go back into the water. Here in front of me then, we have an array of Carp Care equipment ready for when the fish is on the bank and in your net. You've done the hard bit, and this bit is where we can take good care of them on the mat and good care of them on the bank to make sure that they go back safe and well. So here then, we've got a cradle type mat, we've got a flat mat, and we've also got a cot type mat. So different situations, horses for courses, etc. For me, something like this is perfect. What it does is it gives ample padding. You can see that, nice and thick. And as you can see, it also Velcros out as well. Gives ample padding for big fish. I've had fish to just shy of 45 pound in this mat in this country, and it's perfectly sufficed for most of the lakes you'll find abroad, unless you go into those real big sort of inland seas that are gonna catch 60, 70 pound monsters. Something like that is gonna be perfect for this. Huge surface area, and it's off the ground. There's sort of mesh pieces in the bottom, which allows the water to flow through, so it's not that heavy. It's also made out of our safeguard material as well, which you can also see this little water bucket is too. It's very, very durable, very, very waterproof. So it keeps everything in, including the fish. As well as mats, I'll just quickly touch before we move on actually onto the flat mat. This is more for me, more of a rover style mat. It's very, very light, which is also very, very beneficial to those that are willing to move around, go stalking, etc. Rolls up very small, doesn't take a lot of room in your equipment, but again, it's very thick, so offers good padding. Personally, if you're a mobile angler, that's probably the one for you. Moving on then, you'll probably see these beauties in front of me, which I've been very, very impressed with in the last couple of months having used them. They are the camo carp retaining slings. Now, you've got two sizes. This is the larger one, and as you can see, it's probably more suited to the angler that's looking for really big carp, the specimen hunter, that whether probably 45 pound plus, really good on the continent in Europe. And not only that, but as some of the larger, more circuit type waters in this country, this is the one for you. This can easily take a carp up to 70 or 80 pounds. And again, it's probably a really good all rounder. If you only want to buy the one, I'll probably buy that one. If your fishery is more of a smaller type venue, so 20, 30 pound carp, this will definitely suffice. This is the smaller one. Now the beauty with these is you've got a retention sling in a little pocket here, or retention cord, sorry, I should say, in a little pocket here, and that easily fits onto these little toggles and retains in the edge. Bright yellow as well, so you're not gonna miss it. If I quickly undo that, you'll see, very, very easily see my hand through there. It's fully mesh, so there's not much in terms of material, so that allows a good amount of water flow to come through and make sure that our carp are happy in the edge. Just a last point on this, you'll see that there's some Velcro there, and what that does is that undoes, there's a foam bar through the middle of it, and if your fishery doesn't allow retention slings, this simply, you can simply remove them, and this simply becomes a weigh sling instead. So if your fishery doesn't allow you to retain fish in the edge, then take those out. Best of both worlds, you don't have to buy two pieces of equipment. Moving on then, finally, last but not least, probably one of the most important bits, is your net. This is where the carp's going to end up when it comes out of the water. This is the two piece. This is the safeguard landing net. And there's also a one piece as well, which is obviously more conventional, just a 6 foot pole. Now you're probably asking me, well, what's the benefit of a two piece rather than a one piece? If your place or your fishery allows a boat, it's so much easier to net a fish with a 3 foot pole from a boat as it is with a 6 foot. You don't want to be taking up too much space in the boat. It's ideal for things like that. Not only that, but we spoke a little bit about the roving angler, the roamer, with the mat. With this, you can fit yourself into tiny little poke holes in and around snags, etc., when you're trying to extract a fish from a very tight space or a tight swim. Absolutely perfect for that style of sort of situation. Net float goes without saying. Personally, I find them useful because if I'm in my waders and having to wade out for fish, a net float just keeps the net on top of the water. Some do sink, especially if the water gets in the pole, which can happen. If it's on the bottom, yeah, it's not really useful when you've got your PB at the net and you're trying to find it in the edge. Last but not least, the width of the net. It's 42 inch. A lot of fisheries now have a minimum sort of width of the net or diameter. 42 inch is a bog standard. It's safe, it can fit some very large carp in. And also you'll notice the holes in the mesh as well. They're not too big, not too small. A lot of the time, sadly, a lot of damage is caused to fish with people when the fish is in the net. We're excited, we're buzzing, and the fish is rocking about in the net. And if things get caught, for example, hook, points, eyes, etc., in larger mesh holes, then that's where some of the damage is caused. So the small mesh in that gorgeous looking camo is perfect for things like that. Hopefully we've spoken you through just about everything. There really is a mat, a net mesh, a sling for every situation. So please take a look at them. Every single one is befitting to a certain situation. And so far, I've got to admit, I've managed to use all of them. And I quite like them all. Take a look, especially these, you'll like these, as do I. Yeah, good bits of kit. And keeps those fish safe when they're on the bank.